I think of somebody who's a criminal mastermind, who's devious, calculating, cunning. What we don't think of is a geeky 24-year-old.
Gerry came across friendly, positive, upbeat.
Everyone has a thing they're a nerd about. It seemed like Gerry's was business.
I created QuadrigaCX for buying and selling Bitcoin.
Canada's largest cryptocurrency exchange.
Are we hanging out with Mark Zuckerberg right now? Is that what's going on?
Gerry was traveling a lot. Maybe that was him avoiding something.
The exchange suddenly stopped working.
This is an astonishing story. Gerald Cotton passed away, and he took the passwords with him. And that means $190 million of customers' holdings are locked inside, and no one can access them.
I think it was at that point I was like, oh, crap. I wanted to find out if there was a community I could chat with about this.
There were so many different pieces to this story, so many questions.
His wife was the only other person with him when he supposedly died.
There was speculation around whether she was in on it.
She's dancing at her husband's funeral.
That didn't make sense to me.
Something is up.
There's people suggesting that maybe he's not dead.
This could be an exit scam.
People are suspicious, especially when their money is involved.
At that point, the story just goes nuts.
I immediately was questioning everything about the story.
There were definitely a lot of rumors.
Gerry faked his own death and run off with the money.
Organized crime, Russian mobsters.
It's possible that his wife could have poisoned him.
Who can you really believe?
Either I know a guy who screwed up and lost $250 million, or I know a guy who pulled off one of the greatest crimes in history.
Gerald.
Yes.
What's your story? You were born, now you're here. What happened in between?